know what's so funny? People say that about 808 Heartbreak. They said 808 Heartbreak was such a musical classic that he didn't have to say nothing on that shit. You could listen to that whole album just musically without him saying a word, and you still feel it.
So he made that beat also. That's his beat. I feel like I heard that somewhere else though. I feel like it was a sampler. He does things, man. That wake up, right, that was from something else. I don't know what it's from, but I'm pretty sure that's the sample from somewhere. Okay. Alright.
So you got that out your system? You good?
Yeah, that's my shit. Scootity whoop. That's that shit, you bugging. Scootity whoop.
Yo.
What is he not saying that everybody else is saying?
Hello.
But people, niggas, if he pick the
top, play that. Let's compare it.
What song?
The same shit. Man's not hot.
Are you gonna hear the man's not hot?
To Shrek.
But that was made to be a joke.
This is a whole track.
So this is not made to be a joke. The scoopity boop.
I think he making fun of all of these whack ass shitbag rappers.
Everything Kanye does has a meaning to it.
I think he was mimicking this song per se.
And then he
wants. I don't think he was making fun of everyone.
And then he wants to say, "Oh, keep the balls out on this one."
That's what that's like he's making fun of somebody else. He's laughing at all of these.
I hate this. I don't want to. I ain't saying no names because I ain't hating on nobody this week.
He's like, watch this shit go platinum.
Scoopity.
Scoopity. Boopity boop.
Yo.
Nigga said.
What's good? Hold on for a second. Yo, listen. This is episode 49.
49.
No Disrespect Podcast. Cool ass Trev.
Pukina Dream, as always.
And Holly, yours truly.
And on the phone today, we got my man Future. What's good, y'all? Say what up.
What's going on? This is Blog Future. You know, representing AGS since 1982.
There you go.
Ambitious Society.
Ambitious Society.
Dude?
What's good?
Hey, much, brother. How y'all?
We just started, and we were talking about the scoopity poop shit. It's very, very, very much heavy. So we're going to talk about that today, but we will be over here debating on, is this a serious song? Or is he, what is, we don't know
mocking.
What he's doing.
Yeah, is he mocking?
This is Mr. Bell in 2377, the producer, Future. Make sure you talk loud too, because we got you on the speakerphone. All right,
I'm here. Y'all hear me?
Yeah, you good.
We got you.
Okay.
I told ya.
I think we gotta play it back for him. Play it back for him. Scoop diddy whoop.
You just want to dance. We this ain't Soul Train. I felt the same way when I heard that. I said, this is Pootie Tang. If nobody's seen that scene in Pootie Tang when he had the tape with nothing on it, and everybody, he sent it to the radio, he's like, yo, I got the new Pootie Tang.
And it's called.
Yeah, and it's called. And niggas like, yo, this shit is hot.
I think one thing with Kanye right now, even doing that, and a lot of people, just for me, just watching on social media, you know, and everybody saying he trolling, but at the same time, he forcing people to think.
Exactly. That was his whole thing. That's his whole thing with the interview.
They think it's hot. They really gonna think like, yo, this is.
I think, well, he always thought outside the box.
So because I think it's hot, what does that mean? What are you saying, Future? Because I think it's hot?
Yeah, people will really, like, walk around singing poopity scoop. Like, people nowadays fall for so much things, and I think through the whole week of everything that he's been saying, and this is just my opinion, he's showing how gullible people could be, how people could be controlled and forced to like this shit based off the mob. What the mob agrees is good and right and correct. So right. He's trying to, you know, go against all of that. All
right, Fuse peeping. Me and you go back like bra straps, right?
Yes, sir.
I could have swore, correct me if I'm wrong, I heard you back in the days talk about some bum skilly, bum skilly, bum bum.
I did.
Yes, I did, nigga. Stop lying.
specs up for you.
Let me get that. He sang it. That's why he's laughing. What's the difference between Bubba Skinnerly Bump Bump and Stupid and Poop?
Wait, hold on.
Please correct me.
Hey, that's the difference. Hey.
But it had a good beat, it was catchy.
That's what Kanye just did. All I'm saying, that's all I'm saying. So, trick or treat, turn my beat.
Right, that part.
So, can you tell us that part? So was that hard, or was that just some nonsense, or was it just music? I'm just saying.
It goes further than the man's not hot, if you ask me. But he was okay. That
right there, you making a point right there. I don't know what kind of point you're making.
Yo, but listen, I think we all agree that there was always music out there like that, right? Kanye respects the culture of music. Daz FX is respected the culture because they came from an umbrella of lyricists.
Right.
EPMD,
yeah.
K-Solo, exactly. All of that. We get that. Now, let's get to the real nitty-gritty. Let's talk about the interview. First of all, before we get to the interview, let's talk about the hat. Let's talk about the hat. Let's talk about the picture in the hat.
The MAGA hat.
Right. There's two pictures of him in that hat. Now, one picture is him coming out of a building, he's wearing the hat, right? Mm-hmm. The picture that made it hot was, it was him, Leon Cohen, and I don't know who the other white man was. But we all focus on Kanye because of his dark skin.
Of course.
Now, my point was, when I was like, okay, everybody, we're going to target Kanye, but then we got to look at Leon. Because to me, I feel like Leon, this is a man who has made millions off of black culture. Mm-hmm. Def Jam. He still got, what's some label he got now? 300 with all the Scoobity Scoop bullshit rappers on the label. He could have went and told Kanye the family, what's that about? I feel like he should have said something too.
Listen,
as much money as he
did. Say he did.
True, all right, but peep it. Now you got, all right, as an artist, right? I'm just talking about period. Let's say you a painter. And you painting. A painter will put a dot on the wall. A dot.
Ooh.
Bam. And put that shit in the gallery and people will stand there and try to figure out this fucking dot. I'm gonna be like, oh, that's a dot. Somebody like, no, this is a window to your soul through this, that, and the third. Exactly. So when it comes to artistry, there's no limits. You don't have to do things a certain way.
Okay, that's true. But when you putting on a particular item, and it doesn't represent to positive within your people, what does that show your people when it come when it's you and you looked at as an icon, a public figure, and you the one that's more have been as outspoken as he's been in his career of what? He's been in the game, maybe 20 years now?
Okay. So what's the problem? Is it the hat or is the slogan? Or is it the fact that Trump had the hat on and that was his hat? It's because Trump didn't make that hat.
Yes, he did. Trump ran the campaign on Make America Great Again.
Right.
He,
so that's
he
his
coined
hat.
That slogan.
Right.
The
okay,
slogan
so,
is his.
All right. He owned that slogan, right? Okay, granted. Well, we know that Trump is not doing that, right? So Kanye wearing it, why is it so negatively on him? Like, why is the, it was negative on Trump regardless, but why is it negative on him? Why is
he
not shining the light? Why is it not like, no, I'm gonna make America great again. Me, Kanye West, not Trump.
Then don't wear something that this man, he's basically either breaking, like, I wouldn't say he's breaking down the black community, but he's focusing on that is mainly negative towards black people.
You think so?
Why? Yes. That's what I'm saying. Why?
Because when was America great to black people? Tell me.
What was America great to people? Why do we have to think about race?
It has always been about race.
Because we're the only ones that were slaves.
And we're the only ones affected by this America being so-called great.
Black people always want to be the fucking victim.
Right? I've been saying things based on blacks in America, right?
Uh-huh.
I never try to say all people or this, that, and the third. You know what I mean? Because other people are doing what they want to do. They push their agenda. And you know what? Crazy, what I'm about to say, but it's the truth. I got no problem with the agenda that Trump want to push because he's represented for what he represents for. And I think that's something that black people need to start paying more attention to. Yo, stop saying, stop jumping into these other fights with all these other things and let's focus on what we're doing and what we need to do for us.
Right.
We don't got to keep including everybody into what we're trying to do.
Absolutely.
So when I see Kanye, what broke my heart about him aligning himself with that, because at first I was like, yo, that's crazy, tripping. Right? Mm-hmm. And I'm like, but then I also know that Kanye says and does things that I don't catch on to probably like a year later. Mm. Me myself, like just being honest. It caught our attention. A lot of shit that he was saying, a lot of shit he's been doing this last week, it caught my attention. It hurt, and it made me look at him differently. And then I watched the interview with him and Charlamagne, and the shit cleared up a lot of things for me.
No, that interview definitely cleared up a lot of shit, and I understood exactly, you know, what he's going through. It cleared up a lot of the Jay-Z, Kanye brother thing. One of the things I saw in that interview, what I didn't like, right? Kanye said, it's time for unconventional thinking. And what he said, to make America great again, is for the unconventional thinker, right? Trump made it into office. He has no political background, no law degree, none of that shit.
None of it.
He's the unconventional person in the White House, right? Mm-hmm. So for him, that gave him some type of enlightenment to be like, I can do whatever I want to do. Now, when he said that, I was like, I felt like when Obama made it to office, if you wasn't unconventional at that point, a black man in the White House as president, you couldn't get no more unconventional at that. Because we have never thought we would ever see a black president.
But he was a politician, though.
But the fact of the matter is that we knew in our minds from years that we ain't going to never get no black president. That was an unconventional thing right there that should have made people say, I can really do whatever I want to do. It shouldn't be some
man. But I think they did.
No, I think it went opposite.
I think black people got comfortable and just went full niggerish.
Right.
And said, oh, I don't need to do nothing no more. We got a black president. He going to take care of us. And now Trump is in office making all of y'all uncomfortable, especially the ones that ain't do shit for 8 years. And now they like, oh, I need to get my shit together.
And that's how I felt like we should have been on the board, like where we finally got, you see the future now. We here. This is unconventional. Before him, everybody else was white.
White men. Right. That's conventional.
You got a black politician. Cool. You know what I mean? I felt like you ain't have no faith in this black man being the president. As much faith as you got in that, now you can do whatever you want. Now you feel you can do whatever because Trump made it into office. You should have been feeling that way when fucking Obama made it past the primaries and all that other shit. In the first 4 years before he got on, you know what I'm saying? That's the part I didn't like. Like, we supposed to, like I mentioned last week with the boycott shit and the protest. Every time some shit happened, black then people always want to create a coffee shop now or a donut shop because fuck them. I'm going to create my own. No, you're supposed to have been created that shit. Something shouldn't have to happen for you to say, I'm going to create my own shit.
Reaction, man.
It shouldn't be like that. And, that should be the unconventional part right there. We shouldn't have to react to every action, especially black people. There's so many actions towards us. We reacting too damn late.
But they do.
Which is why we're always behind. Like we said, we reactionary. when we should be
actionary.
Visionary.
Yeah, visionary.
And I think that that has a lot to do with the comment that he said about us making a choice about slavery.
People don't understand that. When you have a new way of thinking or a new way of doing things, it always does what? It stirs controversy because it's something new. You're saying something that's going against the grain. So for him to get up there and say, yo, you know what, I think slavery is a choice, that shit actually got people starting to think, like, well, hold on, was it a choice?
No.
I mean,
see,
a lot of people said it different ways.
See, but time out. You got, when you look at what he said for 400 years, slavery, that sounded like a choice. What he should have said was, he should have fixed it up and said, like, listen, people did rebel. He forgot that part. He didn't mention the whole thing. He just said one half of that statement, which is false. The true part about that statement is you had your Nat Turners, you had your Harriet Tubman, you had all those other people there who rebelled against slavery and said, I'm out of here. But then you also had the conventional house nigga, like, nah, I'm comfortable here serving master. I don't want to die. You know what I mean? I'll wait this shit out.
Yo.
It's about fear, though. Like, yo, it's all about fear. It's fear. And I think that's what Kanye is saying. It's about people being afraid to even jump out and do or speak how they really feel and push what they want. Now, so as a people, ultimately, we've been in fear for 400-500 years. Like, we've been in fear. So, yeah, you were scared to run off that plantation. You were scared to fight for that or leave with Harriet Tubman. You know what I'm saying? So nowadays, people are still in slavery right now. People are afraid to quit that job and push what they want in their dreams. They're afraid that they're comfortable living in the house. Waking up every single day. Yo, every day I wake up to go to work, I'll be like, I'm not going to work. But if I'm not going to be fearless and say, yo, you know what, I'm going to film this podcast, I'm going to push this clothing line, I'm going to do these things, I'm just going to be happy with this 9-to-5, but that's slavery right there. So that's a choice. You know what I mean? Now, is it the same as getting your ass whooped on a tree? I mean, I think, like, yeah, because you can lose your job and don't have no money to pay your bills. So, you know, that's the same as getting whipped on a tree. You know what I mean? So,
yeah, they're
gonna
whip
I just think overall, with the conversation that we have, it's about fear and it's about being different and being visionary, ultimately.
Yo, Kanye.
You gotta stick together first, though.
Kanye, in the last two weeks.
And at the end of the day, we sitting here having a whole conversation about arguing against what Kanye did. Not even, you know,
Kanye
us. Like, Pete, but a lot of people didn't agree with it off the rip. A lot of people kind of judged him and was like, they looked past his skin like, oh, he's black, he's a black man. Maybe he's saying some truth to it. At first, it was just like, everybody was like, oh, he's bugging or, oh, he's this. You just all the way jumped to to defense or whatever the case may be, versus giving a man a chance to explain. And I think people do that with a lot of people in a lot of situations.
That's because what we talked about before, that's the trendy thing to do. All it takes is one person
to
say, oh, I'm criticizing him, and then everybody jump on before they even heard the full interview.
But I don't think he said what he wanted to say. Kanye really, he thought outside. Whatever he be thinking, he says. Without thinking. That's why when homeboy at TMZ was like, fam, I don't even think you're thinking. Because you are, like, Kanye is in his own box. His own world that he created.
You know what's so funny? This is how I look at it. Kanye, in the last few weeks, he just woke everybody the fuck up.
You think so?
Absolutely.
So you don't think because
guess what?
People up.
Now, look. Now,
nah, I think that's all.
Now, people of color, we are not unified at all.
Absolutely.
Everybody's doing their own thing, trying to get by. Correct. But one thing that you can make people unified is each of them having a common enemy.
And which would be?
Kanye. Everybody is down at Kanye.
Hey, I'm like Trump.
No.
I think we're together.
Right. You like Kanye, but Kanye been on everybody's discussion. Everybody been talking about Kanye. Everybody's talking about, oh, you wrong. Everybody's been looking at history. When the last time you looked up slavery and stuff like that? Not you per se, but I'm saying anybody. Since Kanye made that statement, people been looking. Nah, he's bugging because back in this day,
do you think he just did this for... for sales.
No, he's gonna sell regardless.
I don't even think
he got on the track and said boopity boop. He know he gonna sell.
I don't even think he. This is not about publicity. This is not about an album. None of this. This is. I don't even remember him really promoting the album like that. He really does shit unconventional. If you think back, Kanye doesn't. I think the only album he really promoted was fucking the joint with him and 50 Cent. When they were supposed to have that album out together. Oh, and he didn't even promote that because 50 Cent promoted that more than Kanye. You know what I'm saying? Kanye, I don't think he promoted albums since fucking College Dropout.
He said artists should have CEOs. Did y'all hear that part?
Yeah, and he's right.
Not managers.
He said to verbatim, he was like, the music industry isn't designed for artists to be CEO. It's designed for you to make your music and tour. Okay. That's all they wanted you to do.
Your whole life.
That's great.
But that makes sense. Look at New Edition. Right. Let's go back.
TLC.
Hello.
Man, the Boys to Men.
Hello. We can name them. So it definitely makes sense.
What's the Sugar Hill Records? They black and took advantage of Sugar Hill's gang. You know what I'm saying?
Man,
can't nobody on Sugar Hill.
There's a method to his madness, man.
I think he's really speaking his mind. He says it. He said, him being a free thinker, he wants everybody to think outside the box. What he's saying is, okay, don't be mad at me because I think this way.
Right.
You should think a certain way, too. And we should
collaborate.
Yeah,
absolutely.
And agree to disagree.
Come to a common ground. Absolutely.
I get that.
The only problem I have with that, you know what I'm saying? When you start pushing that kind of line, it's like it's dangerous for African Americans because now we thinking individually. You know what I'm saying? And for me, and it's just my opinion and just the way I think, is that we need to think collectively. That's I always push black nationalism, you know what I'm saying? And I'm not a person that's for all this inclusion shit when we don't got our shit right. You know what I'm saying? So when I am, mm-hmm. they go, when speaking, like, you know, we all humans and this, that, and the third, yeah, we get all that. I get that. I feel all that. But the thing that's pressing us as black people right now is that we're not united. We're not pushing one agenda. You know what I mean? We accepting and we helping every other people and problem more than we help our own. So that's what my problem is with him. Do I understand what he's saying?
Do you think black?
Do I agree 100% with everything he's saying? No. Do I understand that I haven't probably even reached that level of what he's thinking? I haven't. You know what I mean? I've never been rich as Kanye. You know what I mean? So I don't know what it is to think on that level, but I know where we at right now. Some of the things that he's saying is valid. We need to think outside the box. We need to be thinking more independently as black people. Now, individually, that's something different. You know what I mean? That's just how I see the whole situation. So when you say something like, oh, you should just be a rapper and not a businessman, I think that's like crazy talk. Like, you need a CEO. No, you don't. These rappers right now go on SoundCloud, like Tekashi, and blow all the way up. You know what I'm saying?
But that shit don't.
I don't know.
But these niggas that's doing that shit now, they ain't gonna be around for too long, bitch. You know that's a fact.
I think they okay with a mixtape. I think that it's okay because it's not even about that. It's about the fashion. It's about getting the money to be able to wear these high end fashions.
Right. But see, what he said, what Kanye said was like, we are the CEOs. We are that.
Yeah.
We shouldn't have to go look for it.
When we already it.
We are it. Once when you feel like you something, you when you're like, I want to be a rapper, what you do? He create music, right? Mm-hmm. You hope to get heard, you know, build the buzz. After a while, once you get in the door and you learn the ways, that's when you take that information. That's why he also said, like, they not giving out information. They don't want you to have all the information, which is true. When you get in the door and you learning shit like, oh, this is how I work,
but that's not
then you step off and be like, I can do this.
That's not just with music, though. That's with anything.
But he was just being specific with music and saying, like, yo, they don't give you the They want you to give. They want you to do this. And he's saying, I don't want to be seen just as a rapper. I do other things. I do, as crazy as the clothes look, I do design clothes. I do design sneakers. So I'm not just a rapper. No more. You know what I'm saying? When I came in, I was already unconventional. I had the pink polo. I had the backpack. That wasn't even new when he came out with that backpack shit.
Yeah.
Because Grand Poopa was doing that shit a long time ago.
I understand
everything he was saying. He just really want niggas to think outside the box. And I think
it's nothing wrong with thinking outside the box, but I do think that black people are just comfortable, and I feel like, like you said in the last interview or whatever the case may be, where, you know, you can't just wait till things kind of just, to you, feel personalized, and you're like, oh, well, now I'm, you know what I mean, now it's really a problem, and now I really want to step up and make 10,000 coffee shops, and you should have been did that.
Yeah, if that's what you want to do, do that shit. In all reality,
Starbucks wasn't meant for us because it's a $5 fucking coffee, and we've been drinking coffee for forever. And it's 75 cents in a regular store.
And most of them shits.
Macchiato.
I'm gonna get a black coffee. I could have went to Dunkin' Donuts for that shit. I got a courage. That's what that shit in my house.
Like, yo, again, you know, in this day and time, you know, people have to live without fear, man. Yeah, I mean, even right now, what we doing with No Disrespect Podcast, or what my brother doing with Von Dawn United, what I'm trying to do with Ambitious Sustain City 2, is saying, you know, we want to be independent. We want to have a voice. We want to be in charge of our destiny.
Right.
So, on a small scale, that's what we want to do. Me, once again, for African-American people, is as a whole, that's what we need to be pushing. You know what I mean? That's the only, I can't see nothing else other than that. Anything... I give my opinion on all of this shit that's going on in the world right now, I always reflect it back to the black struggle. You know what I mean? And at the end of the day is, you know, all of us, most of us, or whatever, however you want to put it, we live in a fear, we scared. You know what I mean? And that fear holds us back. So to be a person like Kanye, to jump out there and just say, this shit unfiltered, like Spicy, Jay-Z is saying the same thing on 444.
Yeah.
He's giving you the information. He's telling you. And Kanye just saying it straight up. He's just going to say it straight up. Jay going to put it into different kind of verbs. And he going to show you also. But Kanye going to straight up and come and tell you how he feel.
Names, places, dates. He giving you the blueprint for what?
No, bro, no filter.
Let me ask you a question, though. So, everybody. Why? I feel like, you know, the word boycott and protest was maybe thrown around
too slightly
for Kanye. But it seemed like when you asked, like, they asked Common, and Common said, Kanye's gonna always be my brother no matter what.
Yep.
So why is it like that we're like, people are not.
Look, that's the movement itself.
No, this is the question, but why is it that we're literally like sitting here saying we got like, we're trying to save Kanye and not boycott Kanye?
Kanye trying to save us, man. And y'all don't get it. People don't get it. It's not just fear that we living in. We living in ignorance. Because guess what? My whole timeline is with mad dumb shit that I could just probably live without listening to or even hearing about.
Absolutely.
This nigga, oh, he called you a pussy. Oh, I fucked your girl. Come on. Niggas still doing that? Niggas still worrying about that? When Kanye throw a hat, like, he said that, I think he said that in the interview. I could've rapped about my money. I could rap about me fucking your bitch. Yep. But
standing on the corner selling drugs and that a sell. And
he put a Trump hat on, not everybody thinking politics. Like, oh, well, we should have been thinking from the start.
But then, see, I feel like this. I feel like we had, all right. somehow music has shifted.
And mind you, we're talking to about a 40-year-old.
No, no, but check it out, because
I know
no disrespect to you, but you're a little younger, right? So let me tell you, we had the Jungle Brothers, you had X-Clan, you had Public Enemy, yeah, and they was all preaching and telling us the shit we needed to do for self. We followed that. Somewhere along the line, that shit, that camaraderie and unity was fucked up. Somewhere along those lines, it just stopped going from unity. Even when NWA was telling niggas, fuck the police, that was still like the message, like, pay attention to what these niggas is doing. But somehow, we lost sight of the message and said, fuck it. I want to be entertained.
Because they knew how to control us. They started giving niggas money.
But we had money.
No, we didn't.
We didn't have as much.
And that changed.
We still don't have nothing.
I'm talking about, all right, once you, all right, you can have a rapper.
So the amount just looks different.
You can have a rapper that start off one way, but once the money roll in, he starts changing.
You can't have money and be the same. Well,
you can't, and this is it.
And that's the problem.
And they don't understand. Money nowadays is the new God.
For a lot of people.
For a lot of people.
Not mine.
People sell their soul for money.
Exactly.
So now, everybody knows this. Money is what it is. So people do what they gotta do for money.
And this is why the black community is affected. Because the black community
don't have
a
time.
No. They'll sell.
But what about but that's what I was saying. During the times that we had the unity and the money, let's take it back. Let's take it back to before y'all got here. Me and Rel, we was talking about some drug dealers back in the days.
Mm-hmm.
Right? We talking. Let's say we gonna say 85. To
92. That's the right? Same thing, right?
Boom. During those times, there was struggle, right? Well, we still have struggle, but when you decided, when the young niggas, when they was young, they said, all right, I'm going to take it back. I'm going to do this because I have to. As they got into it and grew with it, they put back into the community slightly. They could have done more. You could have done more.
No.
But they didn't. Yes.
You could have put in more.
I'm agree with you 50% because guess what? Half the time they were destroying the community by selling that shit because they wasn't going to sell that shit in Long Island and the Hamptons and all that shit and come and bring the money in the hood. They were selling that shit to niggas' parents.
They couldn't.
Fathers, aunts,
but what I'm
grandmothers,
saying, they couldn't. They would have
mad crack babies came out of that era that you talk about. They gave back community. They gave us problems, and we still suffering from that shit.
Ain't the same people.
Say that again.
The ones that I had when we was coming up, them motherfuckers wasn't the same as the biggest drug dealers we knew back then. They didn't have that was a totally different thing, and I think. A lot of that shit come through, you know, like if you look at any documentary, they'll say it, right? Like once Superfly came out and once Scarface came out, mm-hmm. Shit changed.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And the reasons and the motivations of trying to get this money changed. So
yep.
Even in rap, you know what I mean? It changed. It became more about
money.
Commercialism
and it became
cars and all of that. It wasn't about.
Oh, I just want to do it because I'm being artsy.
That brick of cheese shit that he had on the corner.
Hold on.
It was about trying to get that new car and being a popping dude in the hood.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, so the dynamics changed. And the affection of how drugs affected our community changed because when my father probably was hustling, they were smoking crack and it was cool.
Yeah.
And they was getting to that bag.
It was cool until we see our generation that was in the 80s grew up and was like, nah, crackheads steal your TV, kidnap kids, and sell them. But before that, motherfuckers was going to the feed, was sniffing coke, doing this, that, and third.
That's
yeah,
true.
No, he's
right.
Coke now, so shit changed.
I think what changed at that point,
in my opinion, changes the dynamics of what the people do. And
think what changed at that point is when we had the mass incarceration.
Facts.
That's what really changed and really messed up the community. Because, like I said, there was drug dealers out there. Yes, they took from the community, but they also gave back a little bit. They didn't say, look, I'm going to buy this building over and replenish it. They gave back, I'm saying a little bit. They could have probably done more.
Taking the kids on a bus trip doesn't justify the fact that you're selling crack to their fucking mother.
Listen, but let's keep it all the way funky.
One
a lot of them niggas,
if
they knew that you could do better and this wasn't your choice, they'll put your ass in a rehab. Mm. Not everybody they was just giving the shit to. They didn't give it to pregnant women. They did have morals and principles.
Somebody
they did
was
have,
selling to pregnant women?
Some
niggas
we
was.
Talking about a lot of them, look. What I'm saying is a lot of them had morals, values, and principles. Right?
Versus now.
And when the mass incarceration came,
come on the block and just start opening up. Nobody.
Niggas was not just doing a shootout in broad day like
no.
I'm talking about a little further.
Now everybody wants. What destroys us, you know what I'm saying? It was the glitz, the glamour, and all the shit, the negative shit that come with making money. You know what I'm saying? So just as much as anybody really affects people in ways that we don't even know because we've never even been, like, that rich. But even when motherfuckers get a little bit of money, niggas step on the block with some new kicks and start acting totally different. It fucks you up and it distorts your original goal because now you're getting what you want easier.
Right.
You know what I mean? So I think, like, you can even look at New Jack. Nina was out there passing out turkeys, but he was still blowing the fucking dreadlock head off.
Exactly. Right in the broad day, slapping a super big ass on down the street with the shotty to his head. I'm sorry. I'd have took the turkey, but I'd have been like, that nigga Nina ain't nothing to fuck with.
Yeah,
okay. All right. This is my last question about Kanye. Why are we like on the gate of boycotting and saving Kanye and wanting and thing like Kanye?
I'm not on the gate.
It's like Kanye got you on the gate of saying
Kanye don't need saving. I'm with Poole.
Right.
No, I'm just saying like what I'm saying not that he needs saving. Like it's not that we're not this week
and
we're not
making
like
a mockery of black.
We're not jumping the gun and saying let's protest him and that's not buy his album
because you
had like
a point. And the longer y'all think about it, the more you step, the more
but the point was for everybody
he's tapping into that fucking that thought about how he's making sense in a way, even if he don't make sense, he's making you think for yourself, which is probably the best thing that anybody has done for us in a long time, making us fucking think, because everybody else is just.
Going with the flow.
Exactly.
Going with the flow instead of being the flow.
Exactly.
Alright,
That's what I think he was talking to when he's the certain things, certain people could feel what the songs he made or, you know what I'm saying, the shit that he just put out. Like, certain people could actually feel it because it's just that. You know what I'm saying? A lot of niggas ain't out here asleep. A lot of niggas is out here woke. So a nigga heard what he said loud and clear.
Mm-hmm.
Off the first come go around, I know. Oh, maybe he. No, I understood it.
Cause I noticed that you changed your tune since last week.
Hello.
When you was trying to crucify me over here, when I was over here like, yo, y'all niggas is bugging. Boycott what? Him?
Yeah.
No, you're right. Cause I, like you say, I had to think a lot more.
And that's what he made you do.
Shouldn't have had
he
to
made
do
me
that.
Think.
Thank you, Mr. West.
No, I think
that's my brother.
We're gonna change the name of this episode to
Thank
You,
Mr.
West.
Yep. Okay.
Thank you, Mr. West. Good looking out.
Because we don't have that money like you keep iterating. And we don't have that, but he does. So he's telling us, when we get to that side, bitch, look out.
And you gotta understand, if you listen to an interview, he breaking down a lot of shit that, a lot of his views and shit is coming from another, not even the rap industry, the fashion industry.
Hello.
Where it's very few of us.
But the fashion industry, that shit is cutthroat crazy.
Exactly.
That shit is cutthroat crazy.
Exactly. And he probably going through a lot of prejudice in that field alone, which is forming his views and opinions on things out here.
Yeah.
Just hear him out. Don't kill the messenger, man.
For real,
he's hear the message first.
Yo, having that much power and influence in this society is very dangerous.
It is.
So anything that you say and you do, you really jumping out there. So he said something and he meant it. You know what I mean? That brother meant it. That don't take away from what he was, you know, the old Kanye versus the new Kanye. But to just jump out there when you could possibly lose everything and lose that base that you have to just say what's on your heart and say what's on your mind and be different. Yo,
he lost that though. When he did the Taylor Swift shit, so he ain't got nothing.
No, I don't think. I don't think he lost that.
Fucking Donald Trump.
He said it.
He does the same thing. So we like fuck Trump. This, that, and the third. I'm gonna tell you something like this. I have yet to see even Obama. I don't know what the. I don't know what changed. You know what I'm saying? Since Obama was in office. You know what I'm saying? The thought. And the visualization of, oh, we got a black man in office, what I could do, yes, I see the change. What Trump is doing, there's a change in that, too, because now we're saying, hold on. If we could elect people like that and put them in office, then anything can happen. So we need to be on point about this. So, you know, I think with anything that's new and different, it forces change. And I, you know, I'm not sure if I'm saying exactly what Kanye said, but that's what I take from what he's been doing this last couple of weeks. And he's forcing people to, you know, challenge themselves, you know what I mean, and to think differently. So, you know, the truth hurts. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
It might not be truth to other people. Some people may agree, some people may disagree, but it forces you to change. And adversity forces you to change, and it forces you to become somebody different. And I'm gonna lightly touch on this. When I was going through my situations of transforming from, like, yo, I'm sell drugs my whole life, right? That's what I really thought at one point, right? I'm gonna be a street nigga, right? Yeah. And then I was forced to be like, yo, you know what? I got 2 felonies. I don't wanna go back to jail. I gotta do something different. You know what I mean? So I had to, like, all right, I'm gonna get a 9-to-5. I didn't wanna do it, never, but I did it, and it good things came of it. But through the adversity of going through what I go through, trying to walk this straight path, is making me grow to want to do shit independently. You know what I mean? I don't want to make another person rich. If this person had an idea that employs me, then I could make up an idea that employs me and employs my brothers and my sisters too. You know what I mean? So adversity, you know what I mean, brings change. You know what I mean? So we need people that's going to jump out there and say some shit to make me be like, nah, I ain't gonna do that, I'm gonna do this. You know what I mean? So we can't always just put people on the cross and just nail them. You know what I mean? Sometimes we gotta look at ourselves, and when we take from that and bring it back to the people that's around us, what we learn and you know, push forward in a better way. And that's one thing, that's why I like about, you know, my brother doing this podcast, because, you know, it's making all of us, like, we all are doing things independently right now. You know what I'm saying? And I've always got to get back to what I'm trying to do, what y'all doing, what my other brothers is doing. This is the world that we live in. You know what I mean? And, you know, there's going to be people and there's going to be situations that forces us to do what is right by us. And we need to take our lessons that we learned and bring it back to everybody that's around us.
Right, brother, future.
And on that note, I guess we got it.
Brother, future out here. Thank you.
I don't even want to say any last word, but that was a good one.
That was a great one.
Shout out to my bestie.
Last thing, and yo, follow ambitious_since1982 SC. Spreaker.com/ambitious_1982 SC. We try to bring, you know, light to a lot of issues dealing with our people and entertain and lifestyle. At the same time, you know what I mean? Definitely follow my brother, Vaughn Dawn United. You know what I mean? It's for the people. And, yo, no disrespect. Family, I love y'all. I can't wait till I come up there. You know what I'm saying? And we could continue to collaborate. You know what I mean? And show what we could do when we put our minds to whatever we want to do.
Absolutely.
Yo, good looking on calling, brother.
Yeah, thanks, man.
Yo, love y'all, man. Peace.
Peace.
One.
All right, so it's thank you, Mr. West.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. West.
Wake
up.
Well, we all woke, we could say that we all woke. Like we have that mindset.
I think I have my days where I'm asleep, but
sometimes it's easier to be asleep.
That shit is hot. I don't give a fuck what fucking cool ass Trevor saying right here, trying to cut my ass, but he can't.
Hold on, before while you're talking, I'm gonna go ahead and pull up Man's Not Hot in the meantime.
Please, because I definitely think he was being funny with this whole
just
album.
So you know, too, Man's Not Hot, 263 million views in 6 months.
Doop, boopity, boop.
Nigga said my mother was asking my son.
Can you be mad at that?
What's that song you in here singing?
Even if he got 1 cent a hit, that's 2.6 million.
Listen.
Lots.
Hello?
Can I get a hit?
Can I get a hit? Can I get a like? Can I get a follow? Hello? Do your thing. Can I get a view? There we go.
Hold on. Man's Not Hot for you.
Sometimes I think I'm too woke sometimes. That's how I think I'm.
That's why I have to go to sleep. He's killing because me. When I'm woke like that and I need to be going, I got to go to sleep. Because I can't. They can't get me. They can't get me.
I be thinking, I be like.
Yeah.
I be thinking I'm just like
this nigga
energy.
Got on. Time out. Did you see this video?
No.
This nigga got on a fucking bubble.
In Miami.
On the beach. And he's already.
I'm in Miami, bro.
Wait, I
think man's international.
I know who this shit is now. I seen a video for this shit.
You seen it, right?
Yeah.
You was one of them 20 billion thousand.
You was 260. Bro, he was number one.
I didn't go on YouTube for this. This shit was on Revolt.
Yes, that was a real video. It's a whole video.
Because matter of fact, this nigga was about to get sued. Because what happened was this video was made during the time of the award show. And he had a bunch of people in the video without their consent. So those 200 something views, whatever money he got, he probably had to give some of that shit away. Niggas don't know that.
Yo, he had 20 niggas on the beach in hot ass bubble coats in Miami.
I saw that. Now I know what you're talking about.
Rice Krispies. Whole time I get with my
Now I get to put that in the overlay later on and compare you guys. Going right to your Instagram page.
Great,
brother.
I appreciate it. My last word is, fuck this nigga.
For real, that's
to your right.
Last words. Thank y'all again. This was dope.
One step closer to your 50, brother.
Yeah,
your goal.
Man, we got 49.
Happy birthday.
Mother's Day next. next week, so happy Mother's Day from everybody.
We won't be here.
No Doubt Disrespect Podcast.
We'll be following up after.
2 Cent Tuesdays coming from Pukim the Dream.
Cha-ching, cha-ching. All right,
look out for that. We got some other stuff in the works, too. We got some other stuff in the works, so I ain't gonna spoil
soon
it.
Some coming.
I feel it coming.
Yeah. Just hold, you know, just keep watching, man. Keep watching. I know we got more than 10 views. I know you see us, because every time you see me in the street, you always ask me about it. Also, shout out to Cognac and Conversations, my people's over there. They asked me for some, you know, my opinion on anything, so I'll shout out to them. Other than that, before I pass it to you, Holly. Black Dot Edison, congratulations. Your daughter graduated in college. Crystal, what's up? Congratulations on graduating college. We see you. She got her BA. She's going to go get a master's. So shout out to Crystal.
That's dope.
Young black educated woman out here tearing up the street. Black Edison, we see you when you get back. One love, Holly. It's all on you, girl.
Just back on that. Me and Black Edison went to go see Slick Rick. Awesome. Never seen them before. But that was an awesome fucking show. It was worth seeing. Thank you for accompanying me, Black Edison, because we definitely had a dope night. Shout out my best friend. She just had her first child. My god, baby. So I'm a godmother. They asked me,
that's what's up.
Do I want to have another baby? I don't feel no different. I'm still okay. I'm okay. So we're not doing that. Other than that, that's it. It's the end of the week for me. New weeks, new days, new money. It's almost my boy's birthday, and we got some celebrations to do
yes,
coming.
Yes, we do. On that note, episode...
Go ahead. Episode what? What you were saying?
49. Thank you, Mr. West. Thank you.
Thank you.